Hello students, in this lecture we will be discussing about the code optimization techniques, which are machine dependent optimization. I hope you must have already seen the machine independent optimization schemes, wherein the architecture of the machine was not playing any role while doing the optimization. So in the machine dependent optimizations, there are three different techniques by which we can reduce the number of line of codes written in the high level language code. So one of the scheme is the register allocation, the second one is addressing modes, and the third one is peephole optimization. Out of these three optimization techniques, we will be focusing more on the peephole optimization technique. However, we can just have a look at the register allocation and the addressing modes also. So in one of the machine there can be limited number of the registers. For example, let's say we have the 8085 microprocessor, in which we have an accumulator, and every operation is performed based on the accumulator. The value for every operation, or the result of every operation, will be stored in the accumulator only. So there we have the limitation of that particular register. Now if we have a different machine in which we have been given a freedom of having many register or many general purpose registers, then we can move the data from one register to the other, and if we are able to reduce the number of line of codes by moving the statement from one register to the other, this will actually be the register allocation technique by which we can reduce the number of line of the codes. The addressing modes also plays an important role in the machine dependent optimization, wherein by changing the addressing mode, we can save the statements, or we can save the number of executions of the statements. Now about the peephole optimization techniques, we have four different methods by which we can reduce the number of line of codes. The first one is the redundant load and store operations. It is about, let's say there is some data item in the memory, and we have brought it to the register, and in the just next statement we are transferring it back to the memory. So we have brought it to the register, we have brought it from memory to register, and then in the next statement only we are transferring it back from register to the memory. So it actually has no meaning of doing so. So we can eliminate, or we can remove those two statements. For example, on the left hand side we have a statement x equals to y plus z, and the assembly language code for this is written as move y comma 0 r0. It means the content of y memory location is brought to r0, then value z is added to the content of r0 register, and answer is also stored in r0 register. So we now have, after the second statement, x y plus z in r0 register, so this content is moved back to memory location x. Fine. So these are the three statements by which any statement of kind x equals to y plus z can be written. See, on the right hand side we have two statements. One is a equals to b plus c, and the second statement is d equals to a plus c. So these two statements are written one after the other. First, a equals to b plus c is performed, and then d equals to a plus e is performed. So depending on the left hand side rule, we have to write three statements for a equals to b plus c, and another three statements for d equals to a plus e. So we have to write six statements for these two statements, or six assembly language code statements for these two high level language codes. Now we have done it like move b r0, move c r0, value of b is brought to r0 register, and then we are adding content c, or the content at location c, in the r0 register. Value is also restored in the added value is stored in r0 register. And then in the third statement, move r0 a means the content of r0 register is transferred to a memory location. So a equals to b plus c is complete after the first three statements. The next statement is move a r0, add e r0. It means content e is added in the content of r0 register, and then finally the value of a plus e, which is there in the r0 register, is moved back to the location d. So here you can see that the fourth and the fifth statement is about move r0 a and move a r0. So So this was the same thing that we were talking about. The content of register is transferred to the memory location, and then in the next step itself, what we are doing that we are moving the content of content of A, which is there in the memory, to the register. Okay, so from register to memory, and then memory to the register, the same content. So it has no meaning. So here we can remove all these two statements. The rest of the content will remain the same. Fine. So this way we can reduce the number of line of the codes. Second is avoid jump on jump. Avoid jump on jump means, let's say on the left-hand side a code is written. There is a label 1 where it has been said jump to label 2. At label 2 it is saying jump to level 3 unconditionally, and at level 3 jump to level 4 unconditionally. So if you have to jump to any level unconditionally, and then this is jump on jump. So level 1 is saying to go to level 2, level 2 is saying to go to level 3, level 3 is saying to go to level 4. So this can be replaced by, at level 1 itself we can say that jump to level 4. Fine. So we have to avoid the jump on jump unnecessarily. Next one is flow of control optimization. It means we have to eliminate the dead code. If anything is written in the dead code zone, we have to remove those dead code. For example, there is a macro defined x as zero value, and then below this there is a code written if x then do something. So now let's see, if x is zero, if x has been defined as zero and it is a macro, it becomes a standard constant and its value will not get changed at the runtime. So if the value of this is not going to change ever, then writing anything which is zero as a condition inside the if will always not allow the if statements or the statement inside the if construct to run. Okay, so what is the property of these condition, or how does this conditions are checked? If there is a positive value or a negative value, or there is a condition true inside the if, the statements written inside the if will run. So here the value of x is 0, false, it will be 0 will be evaluated as false. So if the condition is false, the statements inside the if will never run. So it's a dead code. Why should we write these codes? So the compiler in the code optimization phase will remove this code. Now there is another one, rather than writing the more number of statement, we can use the machine idioms. For example, for I equals to I plus 1. It is not for loop then I equals to I plus 1. It is actually about I equals to I plus 1. We are discussing about I equals to I plus 1. So what we are doing here, we have, if we understand it with a very basic thing, then I equals to I plus, for performing I equals to I plus 1, we will have to transfer the value of I to some register R0. And then we'll have to add a content 1 to the content of R0 register, and then we'll move the added value of added value in R0 to the memory location I. So rather than writing this I equals to I plus 1 in three different statements, we can write it as INC I. It means increment I. So this is the machine idiom, where INC is a mnemonic. We can use the machine idiom or machine mnemonic rather than writing three statements. So instead of writing three statements, we have reduced it to one. So these were the machine dependent optimizations, and machine dependent optimizations will depend on the architecture of the machine. Thank you. Thank you.